Hey guys, I'm really excited to bring to you today's episode, which is the second episode in our series from 1 gold to 10,000 gold, flipping items on the auction house. I'll put the rules on screen right now for those who are new. However, if you haven't seen episode 1, I'll put a link up above as well. You should definitely check it out just to get up to speed with our progress so far. Just a little disclaimer, I had asked in the first episode if you guys wanted me to keep the bags or not that I currently have in my bag slots and in the bank as well. A few of you guys didn't really like them, but I would say the majority of you guys didn't seem to care or just wanted me to keep them. So I'll just keep them since they don't actually harm the core of the challenge. They just kind of save me a few unnecessary trips from the mailbox to the auction house. Alright, so enough rambling. We left off last episode with around 40 gold worth of auctions and 2 gold in our bags. So let's go take a look at the mailbox and see if any of it sold. Okay, sweet. So we got 35 gold of auctions that sold, which is actually a big majority of what we had listed. So it seems like most of the Peace Bloom and Major Roll haven't sold yet, but that's okay. We'll keep listing them. Actually, 2 stacks of the Peace Bloom sold, so they are actually selling just really slowly. And all of our wool sold, our linen sold, so basically all of our cloth sold, which is great. And on top of that, we also won some of the bids on the solid stone that we put earlier. So that will be pretty good money because we won them for only 1.5 silver each. So let's pick these up and relist them. I don't really have much time right now, unfortunately, just to look at auctions. So I'll just do a quick vendor search before I go, and then I'll come back in a few hours when I can actually sit down and look at items, and then we'll go from there. Alright, so it actually seems we have another green up on the vendor search, and this one vendors for 2 gold. Someone put it up only for 7 silver. That's probably a mistake on their part, but we'll take advantage of it and vendor it later. Right now, I'll just make sure to list what we have in our inventory, just in case there's people buying those items in the next few hours, and then when I come back, we'll make some flips happen. It's been a few hours and we're back. So there was actually a comment on my previous video suggesting I should look at the enchanting materials, since these items don't have any deposit costs. So I was originally thinking I could potentially convert small prismatic shards into large prismatic shards. Unfortunately, there's just not really a margin right now, so it wouldn't really make sense. But one item that people often overlook is actually the Nexus Crystal, which is a classic material. So what you can do as an enchanter is you can convert one Nexus Crystal into one small prismatic shard, and then you just convert 3 small prismatics into one large prismatic. And it seems right now there's a few Nexus Crystals up on the auction house for around 6 gold each, and large prismatic shards are going for almost 28 gold. So if you do the math, even if I tip an enchanter a few gold, I mean, I'll still make a profit. So let's grab a few of these and see if we can flip them. So I'm pretty happy we made the call to at least list our items this morning because, as you guys can see, a bunch of our herbs sold, our solid stones that we won the bids for also sold, the rest of our wool cloth sold, and this is just on a Monday morning. So, rule of thumb, guys, if you don't have auctions posted, well, guess what? You'll never sell anything. But, anyways, we'll go ahead and find an enchanter. We'll go and vendor our green from this morning when we were in a rush, and we might actually be able to afford a few more items with our sold listings. We found an enchanter, and I'm telling you guys, this flip isn't all that well known. Even this enchanter didn't even know that you could convert Nexus Crystals into prismatic shards. But, anyways, we ended up tipping him 1 gold to convert them, so hopefully, if it'll sell, it'll be roughly 8 or 9 gold profit. And let's go and buy what's been working well for us. So we'll get some motes of fire for about 1 gold each, and some motes of life for about 30 silver each. And this is what the listings look like so far. We roughly have 60 gold up there, so not too bad. And we did also place a few bids for some Eternium ore as well. So we'll check back later since most of these items should sell pretty quickly, and we'll see if we could push to get to 100 gold. Nice. So we sold all our primal fires and our primal lives, so we made pretty much 2 gold on those. We also sold our prismatic shards. We made roughly 9 gold on that one. And we also sold our rough grinding stones. I'm not sure if you guys remember, but those were from last episode where we bought them for 5 copper each, and we sold them for almost 1.5 silver each. So that's pretty good return. So it seems the large prismatic prices haven't really moved at all. So I'm going to go ahead and buy as many Nexus crystals as I can, and then I'll just have someone convert them into large prismatic shards like earlier. Because right now the profit on each one of them is pretty crazy. It's still roughly 10 gold. So hopefully with those, we'll get to that 100 gold mark. I found someone to convert my Nexus crystals into large prismatic shards, and I wanted to ask you guys, so right now I've been tipping 1 gold to convert them, but I'm curious to know, am I kind of being a complete cheap ass? Like, how much would you guys typically tip? I think I might start tipping a bit more when we start seeing bigger margins on items, but let me know in the comments down below, how much do you guys typically tip for a craft like Lewis? Alright guys, so I've just finished my raid, and before we head to bed, I kind of just wanted to take a look at the mailbox really quickly, just because I'm kind of expecting that the prismatics would have sold by now, and yep, there we go. So not quite the 100 gold we were hoping for, but with this extra 80 gold from the mail, we'll be sitting pretty at 90 gold. Realistically, I don't really want to sit on all this amount of money. Because I mean, we can easily make it work for us throughout the night. So I'll try to see if we can find maybe a few items. Ideally, I'd like to maybe find some new ones that we kind of haven't really tested out yet. So let's take a look and see what we can find. First flip of the night, we'll go and snag these silk cloths. These are going for vendor price. So items that are priced like this, it's really not a risk. So might as well pick them up. We'll also go ahead and grab 20 motes of life. This one has just been working out so well for us. Honestly, we'll just keep churning them until it's not profitable. Okay, so I've been also eyeing this market for a day or so now, and I think I'll go ahead and pull the trigger. The aquamarines have been slowly dropping in price, and my thinking is that some people might still need it to level jewel crafting, and other people, believe it or not, still are buying the cheap miner speed to boot enchant. So we'll try and reset the entire market on this and buy them all the way up to 2 gold. It'll honestly be a big chunk of our money and kind of a small risk, but we can't really make money without taking risks, so let's just try it out and see how it goes. And lastly, I'll grab these cheap copper ores. And I'll also do something similar to what we did with the prismatic shards, but this time we'll try it out with the planar essences. We'll go ahead and buy some lesser essences and just simply turn them into greater ones. Because right now, between the two, there's around a margin of approximately 2 gold. So with everything purchased and listed, this is how our auctions are currently looking like. I'm really hoping that our aquamarines do pan out, because that would be a lot of money that we'd be able to get, and I really want to try and flip a crafted item soon, but we need a little over 100 gold, so let's hope for the best, and we'll check back in tomorrow. It's pretty early in the morning, so as you guys can see, some of the auctions from last night still haven't expired yet. Unfortunately, okay, it seems most of the aquamarines haven't sold. I'm not even sure if we sold any, to be honest. I had kept some in my bags as well, since I didn't really want to list all of them and then risk losing a bunch of deposit fees, and I guess that was kind of the smart play at least. And we'll also run a vendor search while we're here, but we'll leave a bunch of these items up just because most of them just have a 1 copper margin. We will grab the unidentified plant parts just because we can vendor them for 1 silver profit each. Alright, so not too bad. At least all of our copper ore sold. We finally got rid of a lot of our peace blooms and mage royals. Although I did have to bring down the price a lot on those before they actually sold. But overall, we still profited a decent amount on them, so I'm quite happy. Okay, so the day is looking up, guys. There's actually a buttload of motes of life on the auction house for super cheap. We're talking just under 20 silver each. And primal lives are still rocking, like around 5 gold each. So honestly, I'll just dump as much gold as I can into these, and I'm pretty sure we'll be making 3 gold profit on all of them. So this is a prime example of what would have been a real pain without having the bags. So thank you to everyone who wrote in the comments of the first video that you guys wanted me to keep them. You guys are definitely making my life a lot easier. So we'll convert these 280 motes of life into 28 primals, and that should be a pretty good chunk of change. And since we still have about 15 gold left, I think I'll just dump the rest into lesser planar essences and just convert them into greater ones, just like last night, since it was just such an easy flip. And as you guys can see, I just listed the primal lives and they immediately started selling for 5 gold each. So we're really going to make a killing on these ones. Just before I leave for the day, this is what our auctions are looking like. And as we speak, even more primal lives are just flying off the shelves. So I'm really happy about that. The one disappointing flip, though, has been the aquamarines. We still have a bunch of them left, and I've even lowered the price to 1 gold each. I'm hoping they'll sell and I won't have to list them for lower, but we'll see. I mean, worst comes to worst, they vendor for 10 silver each. So if we do have to take an L on that, we can always vendor them. Anyways, enough rambling, I have to head out, but when we come back, we should have enough gold to be able to flip a crafted item I've been really meaning to try for a while now. And we're back, guys. It's been a few hours, and we have our biggest haul yet. So we got 134 gold of sold auctions, most of it coming from the primal lives. We didn't sell any of the silk cloth and the aquamarines, but that's okay. If you list things consistently enough, eventually the right buyer will come along. So we'll just stay patient and we'll go ahead and list whatever didn't sell. Alright guys, so originally I wanted to craft the Bracers of Havoc and flip them, because it's one of the faster selling items in the crafted section and it's also well within our price range currently. Unfortunately, the margin on it isn't that great. We're looking at about 10 to maybe 20 gold at most, and it honestly would eat up most of our capital. So what we'll do instead is I found the Cloak of Arcane Evasion, and honestly, the mat costs are really similar to the Bracers of Havoc. At least on my server, the cost will be pretty much the same, around 70 gold to craft it. And we might tip maybe the crafter around 10 gold as well. And I think we could flip this for over 150 gold. This cape is often used by guilds for one of the bosses in Tempest Keep, the Astromancer. So it does have a pretty good niche use right now. So I think we have a decent chance to sell one. So let's take this risk. I'll finish buying up all the mats and we'll find ourselves a tailor to craft it. Perfect. So I was able to find a tailor that was willing to craft the cloak, and he's only charging us 5 gold. So overall, we purchased all the materials for roughly, I'd say, 70 gold, plus the 5 gold tip, so this craft will have cost us around 75 gold. And it seems that it's typically going for around 150 gold on the auction house, but I don't believe there was any up last time I checked. So if that's still the case, we might actually try and sell it for a little bit more than 150 gold, and we'll see if anyone bites. So these are all our listed auctions. We still have around 60 gold left in our bags. Unfortunately, I couldn't really find any items worth flipping at the moment. Some days are just like that, guys. We really don't want to be buying items for the sake of having things listed. If the price just isn't right, then we'll just sit on the cash that we have until something else pops up. So I just finished my raid again, and I figured I'd check the mailbox, because if the cloak will sell, it'll probably only sell closer to peak raid time. So let's go and see if we have anything in our mail. Unfortunately, I forgot to change the UI to the TSM one to see the gold value, but we did finally get rid of at least a few aquamarines at about 1 gold each. So we are still making money on them, but ideally we'd like to get rid of most of them just because they're not really a hot commodity right now. And we sold also all of our silk cloth as well from last time and some other miscellaneous items. So we got a total of 23 gold from this haul. Unfortunately, no cloak sold yet, so we might have to list it a few more times, but I'm not too worried. And before I head to bed, like always, we'll take a look and see what items we can purchase to post overnight. So I'll grab a bunch of these core stones. Some people tag the price on this for under 1 silver, so we'll go ahead and buy everything up to 9 silver. And we'll do the exact same thing with the rough stone as well, and we'll reset this market to 9 silver. And since we sold all of our silk cloths, we'll go ahead and buy some more. There's even some up here for under vendor price. However, since there's honestly a lot of silk cloth up here, I'll just stay safe and buy everything that's at vendor price or less. So I was just about to show you guys all of our listings, but what do you know? We actually did sell our cloak, but it's only sold 30 minutes ago. So the gold hasn't arrived in our mailbox yet. I just didn't realize it until I went to our sold listings. So I'm super pumped about that. I'm actually shocked that it sold so quickly. So that's really awesome. I know we had said that we'd try to list it for a little bit more, but there was already a listing up there, so we settled for the 150 gold. But I'm still happy about that. That's like a 75 gold flip right there. So with that sale, we'll have roughly 220 gold to play with tomorrow. We still have 65 gold worth of listings from everything that we just bought and everything that hasn't sold from last time. So overall, we're really doing well. Unfortunately, this will be the end of episode 2. But I have a lot more things planned for you guys for the next few episodes. I want to eventually try to buy some patterns from vendors and see if those sell. I've had suggestions in the first episodes to potentially flip some ores into bars. And I also want to get into some bigger high-end items to see if those sell as well. So I'm really happy with the progress so far, and I honestly want to thank everyone who supported this challenge up to now. The amount of love this series has gotten so far is really insane to me. So I really appreciate it. If you guys have any suggestions at all, especially when it comes to certain items you'd like me to flip, let me know in the comments down below. As always, make sure to subscribe, ring that notification bell, all that good stuff. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.